Here, you can see I have written the pattern. This is what? These are all odd numbers. So we have done the addition of consecutive odd numbers. So this is the first one. 1 is equal to 1. You can see it is 1 square. Now this is what? 1 plus 3, which is equal to 4. How many numbers? 2 numbers. So 2 square. Now 2 square is 4. 1 plus 3, 4, 5. This is 9. 9 is 3 square and these are 3 numbers. Now 1, 2, 3, 4. These are 4 numbers. Obviously it will be 4 square. Similarly, 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. Without adding, I can write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That is 5 times, 25. Okay, so this is also a pattern. So from this pattern, you can say that the sum of first n odd natural numbers is n square. Sum of first n, or you can say sum of consecutive n natural numbers is equal to n square. So n natural numbers, these are n natural numbers. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is n. And this is n square. Correct? So sum of n natural numbers is equal to n square. Now the numbers which are not perfect square. Okay, we can find out one more way. How? By subtracting the n natural numbers, n or natural odd numbers. Like for example, we have taken 25. Now what is the first odd number? 21. Then what is the next odd number? What is the next odd number? What is the next odd number after 5? 7. What is the next odd number after 7? 9. So if you get 0 for subtracting the n odd numbers, that means the given number is a perfect square. And if you subtract n odd numbers to a non-square number, right? Let's take, any number. Let's take 14. We start with first odd number, second odd number, third odd number, fourth odd number. See, what has come? Negative integer has come. Na? It is not a zero. You will not get a zero, but your answer will continue. Got it? So for a square number, when you subtract the natural, the odd numbers, you get a zero. Okay? And here, you will not get a zero. So this also we can conclude by saying that if a natural number cannot be expressed as a sum of, this is what we have already said. Okay, this was just an example. Now, on the same method, you have to do the try these on page 94 once again. Find whether each of the following numbers is a perfect square or not. So the given number is a perfect square or not, that we have to find out again. So let's do it. Try these. First one is 121. Okay, I have not written the page. Here, 121. So, children, either you do in your copy or you can make place in your book and you can do it. So, the first one is this. We'll do it. Second odd number. Third odd number, fourth odd number, fifth odd number, sixth odd number, next odd number, Next order number. Next odd number. Next odd number. Next odd number. 21 only. Yes. So yes, 121 is a perfect square. So this is the first one. Then I'll start with the second one. 55. First odd number. Second odd number. Next. So your answer is no. So this is how you have to do, children. Three more are there. You will do it as homework. Okay, now we start with the next topic, that is a sum of consecutive natural numbers. Okay, means a perfect square can also be shown as a sum of consecutive natural numbers. Okay, may not be odd, may not be even. So let's take the example. We take the same example what is given in the book. Let's take this one. 3 square is equal to 9. Okay, now let's assume that this 3 is n. Okay, let's do it. N square plus 1 upon 2 and n square minus 1 upon 2 for this n, the value of n. Okay, 3 square. So 3 threes are 9 plus 1 upon 2 and 3 threes are 9 minus 1 upon 2. 9 plus 1, 10. 10 upon 2 means 5 and 9 minus 1 is what? 8 upon 2 is 4. So what are you getting? 5 and 4. So if you add 5 and 4, will you get 9? Yes, the square number of the n. Yes, so this number can also be, the square number can also be represented as the sum of consecutive natural numbers. These both are consecutive natural numbers. 4 and 5 just come one after the other. Yes. Secondly, how do we get them? We get them from the question only. Just question. जो हमको दिया हुआ है हम उसी को n मानते चल रहे, right? So it is n square plus 1/2 and n square minus 1/2. And that's how we get the two numbers, who is actually the sum of these two numbers are the consecutive natural numbers, who are the sum of the square number of n. Okay, so this is one pattern, and for try these is also given for this pattern. That try these is in page 95, children. We are going to do it now. Bhayanak try these diye hue hain is chapter mein. Okay, interesting chapter. It is an interesting chapter also because there are certain formulas to find out the n natural numbers between square numbers, that is 2n, then subtraction of two consecutive square numbers, that is 2n plus 1, and then the sum of two consecutive natural numbers, that is n square plus 1/2 and n square minus 1/2. Theek hai, aaj hi humne padhe chaaron formula. So let's go to the try these now. Try these of page 95. Try these page 95. उसको पॉजिटिव ले लो या तो उसको नेगेटिव ले लो, दोनों को पॉजिटिव ले लो या दोनों को नेगेटिव ले लो, एक को पॉजिटिव एक को नेगेटिव नहीं ले सकते बिकॉज देयर इज ओनली वन नंबर n ना, सो ईदर यू विल टेक n एज पॉजिटिव और n एज नेगेटिव. सो आई एम टेकिंग n एज नेगेटिव ओनली, सॉरी पॉजिटिव ओनली. 21 square, so the value of n is what? 21. Okay, this is what n. Now hum kya find out karenge, n plus 1, n square plus 1 or n square minus 1. So discuss now.